The internet's been a little bit hard on the HTC One M9 and the phone's not even out yet, so we thought we'd give it a fair trial. Aesthetically, not much has changed, but HTC has proven time and again that it is the king when it comes to creating beautiful metal-bodied smartphones, and the M9 is no exception. You can nab it in black, gold, or this gold on silver colorway, and HTC has tried to improve the ergonomics of the thing by blending the hard edges of the M7 with the smooth curves of the M8. The hardware controls now all fall on the right side, so they're easier to fondle, and as with the M8, you get a pair of sizable grills on the front under which sit some improved boom sound speakers. Whilst the bodywork doesn't give you the most reassuring grip, it's the camera surround that's the least attractive part of the design. Yes, HTC has seen sense in reverting to a single rear camera, but why it's so big and why it has to be squared is anyone's guess. With regards to visuals, there's little change from last year's flagship, as the M9 packs an almost identical 5-inch Full HD Super LCD panel. Whilst it doesn't match the pixel-rich insanity of the 2K displays on the Galaxy S6 and S6 Edge, it's a beautiful screen nonetheless. That's more than capable of delivering great visuals, albeit with a slightly cooler colour gamut than most other smartphones on the market. You're also given a wealth of gesture controls like Double Tap to Wake, which works like a charm, and outside of the lock screen, Double Tap to Sleep, which is damn near unresponsive. A three-finger swipe upwards is a nice easy way to connect the One M9 to media-savvy devices too. HTC's Sense interface has always been a great alternative to the basic Android launcher, and it hasn't lost its charm with version 7 on the M9, which runs Lollipop. It's definitely a case of if it ain't broke, with a near identical layout and feature set to Sense 6. But like I said, it's already working with a good base. The only real additions are the Themes app, letting you customise every facet of the visual experience on the M9, and the Sense Home widget, which displays the apps it thinks you want based on your location and usage habits. It even has a folder suggesting more applications you might want to download, but thus far it hasn't offered any particularly compelling additions. Some of the unique staples from HTC are also present, like support for a new dot view cover with some bonus experiences, and Blink Feet serving up as an inbuilt news stream. Overall, the M9 operates without issue. 3D games like Asphalt run with the buttery smooth goodness that you'd expect from Qualcomm's latest octa-core Snapdragon 810. And whilst there is a little heat build-up now and then, the M9 performs amicably. Elsewhere, the phone's sizeable 2840mAh cell will dry out after a day and a half of use, placing it just behind its key Android competition. However, storage is a big plus, with microSD support up to 128GB, 32GB on board, and the option of 100GB of Google Drive goodness in the cloud too. The camera was arguably the biggest sticking point on last year's M8, so how is the 20MP snapper on the M9? In a word, uninspiring. The sensor is better, primarily thanks to the sheer increase in resolution, but whether it's our conditioning to the overprocessed images of social media, the One M9 produces shots that are simply flat and lackluster. The new internals give you 4K video recording in addition to the wealth of modes we've seen previously, such as fast and slow motion recording, as well as the eye camera interface, which is clean and simple. The lack of image stabilization is detrimental to the phone's low light performance and when trying to capture video whilst moving, but if all you're after is a smartphone that takes serviceable big pictures, then the M9 delivers. The front facer is a little more promising, packing HTC's own brand UltraPixel technology for notably better low light performance, and a wide-angle lens on the hardware side, as well as a beauty mode on the software side. HTC has created a good phone in the M9, and it plays to its strengths in design and usability, but good might not quite be enough for some people when you have to lay down the notable amounts of cash to nab this handset. On the whole, it feels more like a refresh than a true successor, and that means, whilst it won't disappoint you, it's not going to give the latest Galaxies or iPhones cause for concern. For the full review of the HTC One M9, check out recombu.com/mobile, and if you have any questions, just drop us a line down below in the comments. Thanks for watching.
Those geniuses at Motorola have somehow made the Nexus 6 reasonably comfortable to handle, with a thankfully slender body that's gracefully curved.